everybody. In this session, we will learn about determination of rigidity modulus of a given wire by using torsional pendulum experiment. The aim of the experiment is to determine the rigidity modulus of the material of the given wire by using torsional pendulum. Now, let us see the apparatus required for this experiment. Torsional pendulum, stop clock, screw gauge, meter scale and a pointer. This is a torsional pendulum, stop clock, screw gauge and a meter scale. So, now let us see the brief experimental procedure.
The torsional pendulum consists of a metal disc which is suspended by using a uniform thin wire which is fixed to the upper part of this column by using a chunk nut. Now, we are going to determine the rigidity modulus of this thin wire by using this torsional pendulum experiment. First, we are going to fix the distance L, which is the distance between the two chunk nuts, by using a meter scale. For which you have to keep the meter scale like this over this first chunk nut, okay, and then you have to keep the scale like this, and where the 50 marking of the scale is there, you make the marking correspondingly on the wire. Now the marking is carefully noted, okay, and then you have to just loosen this and then lift such that the marking of 50 will come here, and when the marking comes here, make it tight. Now this means that the distance between this chunk nut and this chunk nut, the distance between the two chunk nut is equal to L, which is now set as 50 cm initially for starting the experiment.
After fixing the length of the pendulum, we are going to make a marking on the pendulum by using a chalk piece. So this marking will act as the point of reference for counting the number of oscillations. Now let us understand the concept of what is meant by one oscillation. Now if you take this as the wire of the torsional pendulum and this is a disc, so initially it is at rest, so you have any, you can choose any point of consideration, that may be a protuberance or any chalk piece marking can be made. For example, you can make a marking using chalk piece, or anything can be act as a reference point or point of consideration, okay. So I write it as C, point of consideration. So after oscillating the pendulum, so you can see this point of consideration, which is the reference, this moves to the left extreme of the pendulum and again comes to the center, goes to the right extreme and again comes to the center, which marks one oscillation. So again I repeat, one oscillation is nothing but if this is the point of consideration, if you oscillate the pendulum, this point of consideration on oscillation reaches the left extreme end, goes to the right extreme end and again comes to the center, is called one oscillation. So in this way, we understand what is meant by one oscillation. This concept can be used for measuring the reading. So initially it is at rest or mean position. So when the torsional pendulum is oscillated, this reference comes to the left edge and then it goes to the right extreme and again it comes to the mean position again. So this marks one oscillation.
So with this point of reference, we are going to twist the wire and set up the oscillations. Now you can see this disc is rotating left, right, left, like that you have a series of oscillations set up. Our job is to measure the time taken for 10 oscillations. After measuring the time taken for 10 oscillations, stop the stopwatch and note the corresponding reading.
Now, after taking the reading for time taken for 10 oscillations, for the length of the pendulum equal to 0.5 meter or say 50 centimeter, we are recording the values here, corresponding value here. Yeah, and after which the similar procedure is followed to take the time taken for 15 number of oscillations, and we record it here. After which we find the time period. Time period is nothing but time taken for one oscillation. So if this is the total time for 10 oscillations, we divide it by 10 and we put it here, which is the time period, which is nothing but the time taken for one oscillation. Similarly, this value represents time taken for 15 oscillations. So this total time should be divided by 15, and we put it here, which is the time taken for one number of oscillations, which is derived from the total time taken for 15 number of oscillations. So we are taking the mean value of both and putting it here. This represents the average time period t value, and from this value we find the t squared value and finally the l by t squared value, where l is equal to, and this is equal to, l is equal to 0.5 meters divided by the t squared value. And similarly, the same procedure is repeated for measuring the total time taken for 10 and 15 oscillations for 0.6 length of the pendulum, 0.7 length of the pendulum, and 0.8 meters length of the pendulum. And using the same procedure, we are going to find out the L by T squared values for different lengths, say whatever it may be. In this case, it is 0.6, 0.7, and 0.8. So we take the mean of all the value, which is nothing but mean L by T squared. So the purpose of table 1 is to find out the mean L by T squared, which will be used for calculating the rigidity modulus of the material of the wire of the pendulum. For measurement of radius of the wire using screw gauge, for any measurement using screw gauge, the two important parameters are least count and zero error. Now let us see the procedure to determine least count of the screw gauge. So least count of the screw gauge is found out by first calculating the pitch. Pitch is equal to distance moved by the head scale over the pitch scale divided by number of rotations on the head scale. So if you rotate 5 times the head scale, you can see in the screw gauge that the distance moved by the head scale over the pitch scale is equal to 5 mm. So 5 mm for 5 rotations. So it is equal to 1 mm. The pitch value is equal to 1 mm. So now least count is equal to pitch divided by total number of divisions on the head scale. You know that there are 100 divisions on the head scale. So pitch is equal to 1 mm calculated from the above formula. So the least count value is equal to 1 mm divided by 100, which is equal to 0.01 mm. So the least count of the screw gauge is equal to 0.01 mm. Now let us see what is meant by zero error. This is an example of no zero error. So in this case, the zero of the pitch scale reference line coincides with the zero of the head scale. So this is, at this condition, there is no zero error. The head scale coincidence is equal to 0 division, zero error is equal to 0 division. Since there is no zero error, there is no zero correction. The zero correction is equal to 0 mm. When you tighten the screw gauge, if the zero of the reference line of the pitch scale coincides with the zero of the head scale, then there is no zero error. Next, let us see an example of a positive zero error. So in this diagram, you can see that zero of the pitch scale coincides with six of the head scale, six divisions of the head scale. So in this case, the head scale coincidence is equal to 6 division, zero error is equal to plus 6 division, hence the zero correction is equal to minus 0.06 millimeter. Zero correction is equal to, here in this case the correction is negative since the error is positive, minus 6 into 0.01 millimeter. So this is the least count value. So you get the zero correction is equal to minus 0.06 mm. So now when we tighten the screw gauge, now the two arms of the screw gauge is being closed. Now you can see the pitch scale reference line coincides with the 6 value of the head scale. In this case, the zero error is a positive zero error of 6 value. In this diagram, you see an example of negative error. In this case, the zero of the pitch scale coincides with the 90 of the head scale. So, in this case, the head scale coincidence is equal to 90 division, zero error is equal to minus 100 minus 90, which is nothing but minus 10 divisions, and hence the zero correction is equal to plus 0.10 millimeter. So, zero correction is equal to, so in this case it is a negative error, so the correction is positive, plus 10 divisions multiplied by the least count value 0.01 millimeter. So, that is equivalent to plus 0.10 mm. Now, again similarly, the two arms of the screw gauge is closed. Now, you can see the reference line, pitch scale reference line coincides with 90 of the screw gauge. So, this type of error is said to be a negative zero error. After noting down the error value for your given screw gauge, it may be a positive or negative one.
Now, fix the screw gauge on the wire for which the diameter of the wire to be determined. So, now we are going to take the corresponding PSR and HSC readings.
So, now let us see the table wherein we find out the radius of the wire. So, in this case you find out the PSR, HSC value. HSR is found out from the above formula. Observed reading is found out from the formula which is given above, which is equivalent to PSR plus HSR, and here it is the correct reading, which is nothing but observed reading plus or minus zero correction. Okay. So, in this way you find out the correct reading which represents the diameter of the given wire. So, you find out the series of values and you take the mean value, which is mean 2a. From this mean 2a, we can find out the value of a. A is the radius of the wire. So, now let us see the calculation part of the experiment. The formula includes two formulas. The first one is for moment of inertia of the disc. So, we are finding the moment of inertia of the disc, which is nothing but I is equal to m into r square divided by 2, where m is the mass of the disc in kilogram and r is the radius of the disc in meter. So, you note that the radius of the disc is found out from the circumference of the disc. So, if you have the disc, we measure the circumference of the disc using a thread, or the value will be already given in the disc. So, if you measure it by a thread, then you can use a thread and find out the circumference of the disc, which is nothing but 2 pi r is equal to some value, and from that value, circumference value, you can find out the value of r, which is nothing but circumference divided by 2 pi. The next formula is actually the formula for finding out the rigidity modulus of the material of the wire, where neta is equal to 8 pi multiplied by I into L by T squared divided by a power 4 in Newton per meter squared, where I is the moment of inertia which we previously found out from the first formula, and a is the radius of the wire which is found out from the screw gauge experiment, and L by T squared value is the value which is the mean value which is obtained from the tabular column 1. So, substituting all these values in the above formula, we get the rigidity modulus of the material of the wire. Result: the rigidity modulus of the material of the given wire is thus found out by using the torsional pendulum experiment. Thank you.